I got it.
Come here, touch this. Come on. Okay. You feel anything?
No.
Exactly. If more water was flowing, the turbines would be vibrating. Come on.
Up this way. We're going all the way up to the top, up there.
Following you.
See these pipes? They're called the penstock. Water pressure builds up from the reservoir and is pushed down through those pipes, concentrating on the force of the flow, which goes right through to the turbines.
How the hell do you know all this stuff?
I had two older brothers who were always fixing cars and shit. I was going to school part-time to become a mechanical engineer when shit went down.
Did you ever see him again? Your dad, brothers?
No. Come on, over here.
Let's figure this out. Well, this is gonna be fun.
So now what? Wait, what's going on? What are you doing?
We only rode together a few months, but in all that time, I never saw you volunteer for anything. One of us has to jump down there and clear the intake. So, I'm up. Oh, but you can stand and watch. Okay. Well, it's now or never. Let's go.
Yeah, it's pretty mucked up. I think I can clear it, though. Run back down to the turbine. See if it's vibrating at all. Feel that vibration?
Yeah, but the power lines are still dead.
What? Man, well, it couldn't be that easy, right? All right, come on, let's check out the transformers.
So, your dad and your brothers, what happened?
I don't know. On my way back, I tried calling over and over. I always got a busy signal. By the time I reached the house, it was deserted. The entire neighborhood was deserted. There were flyers everywhere, evacuation orders. I went to the closest refugee camp, but it was overrun. Everyone was dead. Freaks were everywhere.
Jesus, Ricky, I'm real sorry.
Yeah, it was a long time ago. But these are the ones feeding the line from the south.
Any idea what's wrong with them?
No, not a clue. Okay.
Well, it might be a short in the turbine junction boxes, so let's just go down and check it out.
So, what's with you and Schizo? I mean, it seems like you're always on the verge of ripping his throat out.
A few months back, Eddie and I caught him hiding outside our cabin while we were bathing.
What? He's a peeping Tom.
I told him if it happened again, he'd find out that my gun is bigger than his.
Jesus. You know, if Addie was there, Schizo probably wasn't looking at you.
It was all I could do to stop her from neutering the bastard.
Ouch.
Right? Never piss off a woman who knows how to use his cabin. Here, boost me up.
Okay, got it.
Here, I got the gate.
Come on. Junction room's right around here. Oh, God, what is that smell?
Freaker nest. From the smell of it, more than a couple. Stay close. How many Molotovs you got with you?
Enough.
Okay, remember the drill. You light them up, I knock them down.
It's been a while, but I remember.
Good?
Yeah. They really don't like visitors much, do they?
Can you blame them?
Whew. Well, they better get used to this shit. You know what? As of today, I'm claiming this for Lost Lake Camp.
Power to the people.
All right, let's check the junction boxes and get the hell out of here. This is it. You ready?
Yep.
Houston, we have power.
Nice work.
I couldn't have done it without you.
Come on, let's find something to block the door in. I don't want to have to come back up here every month to clean this shit out.
Wait, you're gonna be here in a month?
What? No, I don't know. You just... Jesus.
I'm just fucking with you, Deep. Come on. So, why'd you ask about my dad and my brothers?
I don't know. He just, he never mentioned them before, so... You know, I'm sorry if it's something you didn't want to talk about. Okay, Ricky. Ricky, not now. You can... Come on, we gotta get moving.
А я, как говорится, мой старый вернул. Это что, не еда? Алло?
I supposed to ask. I already knew why. Iron Mike's bullshit. Now.
We had been riding together for, I don't remember, a couple months. Deacon.
Okay.
Okay. There was this one night, and I remember it really clearly. It was snowing outside, and Boozer was snoring. Remember how he used to snore? I swear, I thought he was going to bring a horde down on us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, well, pretty much hasn't changed.
Anyway, he thought everyone was asleep, and you were sitting outside by yourself, like you always did, and you were staring at something. You didn't sleep the whole night. Let me see the photo, Dee. Come on, please. This is when I knew.
What'd you know, Ricky?
That I didn't want to end up like so many of us here, trapped in the past or running from it. I want to look forward. Okay, not back.
This isn't what you think it is. Okay? Are you sure it's them?
I saw the mark on his back.
We're from Lost Lake Cab. Iron Mike has a treaty.
Well, that was a really good. If they put it, keep your head down.
Take care. Stop. What the hell?
Yeah?
What do you mean? Son of a bitch!
Hey, hold it, buddy. That's what you did there.
Freeze!
nothing.
I think that's the last of them. No idea. Back in the day, dealt with a few tweakers who acted like that. I think they're on PCP or whatever that other shit is.
Bath salts. Remember? That was becoming a thing before everything went down.
Right, yeah. Come on, let's see if they messed up our bikes. I'll just take these. Okay.
care Mike's treating with these bastards is gonna hold?
I don't know.
Fucking rippers, after what they did to Boozer's arm, after what they did to Lisa, what?
This was clutched in one of their hands. What happened? Did you guys have a run-in, you and Boozer, with the rippers before you stole the antibiotics?
I don't know. Look, whatever Carlos thinks I did, ain't gonna compare to what I'm gonna do to him if I ever see the son of a bitch.
Come on, let's go.
Sharif. We got ambushed by a group of Taliban heading the other way, and they were in flatbed trucks decked out with ZU-23s, modified anti-aircraft guns.
Big guns?
Yeah, really big fucking guns. Our Humvee exploded, went over a cliff, right into the Hari. You know how hard it is to drown in Afghanistan? It's hard. The place is one giant goddamn desert. Anyway, I was thrown clear. When I came to, the Humvee was upside down on the river. I swam out to see if anyone survived. I pulled a body back to shore, and I did that seven more times. And by the time I pulled in Tanner, my Sarge, I was done. And when I came home, I don't know, I bought a bike, spent a couple of years on the road, just moving from place to place, and, Okay, so by the time I finally settled down, I got a job at a bike shop run by this old guy named Jack. And he ran the club. The press, that's what we used to call him. He patched me in himself.
Wait, Jack, I remember Boozer talking about him. He was in prison or something.
Some bad shit went down and he ended up taking the rap. In the morning, you can get whatever tools you need and we'll finish it up then. There'll be fewer freaks out.
So no hot shower tonight? Okay, but I want to show you something first.
Ricky, it's been a long day.
Come on, you know a lot about the freaks. I just want to show you something you might not know. Come on, we're out here anyway.
Shit, okay.
Let's go.
Can I ask you something?
God, like I said before, could I stop you? I don't know what you mean.
I mean, why do you still wear the cuts? You and Boozer, it's not like you're trying to recruit anymore or staking out territory.
No.
A couple of guys I worked with at the plant wore colors on the weekend. I asked them about it once. They said they wore them as a way of saying, fuck you, to, I don't know, the cops, authority, the government. So what are you rebelling against?
Whatever's left. Look, we wear them because we wear them. What do you want? I mean, no idea about Boozer, but I ain't trying to say shit. It's just... cut? That's who I am. I've done a lot of stupid shit in my life, but joining the MC, well...
No, not like this. Watch. I've come out here a few times to see them. They stay in those old machine buildings and they come out every night like someone's ringing a dinner bell, right? When it's morning, they go back inside and what, hibernate?
You mean you never went down there to see?
Aha. Oh, one time I got way too close, and a dozen of them started chasing me. It's like poking a hornet's nest. Come on, let's get out of here. It's getting dark.
Hey, where the hell have you been all day?
Nice to see you too.
Yeah, well, Schizo said you and Deacon took off, and I was worried.
Addy, I'm tired, okay?
Oh, that's rich.
Hey, Deacon, thank you.
Yeah, well, just let me know when you're ready to tackle that transformer. I'll be around.
Sure.
It's bullshit.
What is your problem?
No, no, what is your problem?
I just said, I'm tired. That's it.
Okay. I'm sorry. Like I said, I was worried. It's not like you to just take off without talking to me.
Okay.
So that's it?
Too bad.
Schizo.
Speaking of Schizo, I wonder what the hell he did all day.
Lips pulled back, bury her teeth like, I don't know, a rabid dog or something. She jumped on this guy.
Tak do licha, debil.
A college kid.